You know those days where everything seems bad? Stress, irritability, tiredness, and even depression can be signs of bad eating. Did you know that? Just like sleep can affect our eating also can affect our mood. We even made a video about what foods improve sleep and mood. So if that's your problem, click on the video to learn more about them. In cases of fatigue, worry, and tiredness, the body seems to ask for a chemical reward in the form of serotonin, a neurotransmitter responsible for the sensation of wellness produced through the consumption of sugar and fat. Have you ever noticed that on days when you are anxious about something, you end up eating more and sometimes even compulsively? We also have a video on our channel about what food can help you in cases of anxiety and depression. Have you watched it yet? The fact is that, in the last 10 years, many doctors, dietitians, and psychiatrists have been investigating how much our eating habits contribute to our mental states of euphoria and sadness. With all the studies, a new field was born, nutritional psychiatry. Isn't it interesting? Are you enjoying this video? Then give it a thumbs up to help the channel. But it doesn't relate only to our mind. Our intestines can also be harmed when we don't eat correctly. We also have a video about the link between these two organs. Watch it, you will like to learn more. Eating bad damages the brain through a process known as oxidative stress, which is the release of free radicals of oxygen in the body, something that happens naturally and builds up as we age. An unbalanced diet ends up accelerating this buildup. On the other hand, things that are good to the brain are anti-inflammatory, simple fats, monounsaturated or polyunsaturated, and antioxidant foods like fruits, vegetables, and nuts. These foods have a restorative effect on the brain, protecting it from oxidative stress and inflammation that affects the balance of neurotransmitters responsible for regulating our emotions. Interesting, right? To the researchers, fats and sugars are bad for us, not because they make us sad when we gain weight and feel bad about the numbers on the scale, but because our eating habits make us get sick, reduce our immune system, and end up affecting our mental health. According to the study, people who have a Mediterranean diet rich in fibers, olive oil, green leaves, fruits, and vegetables have only 33% chance of developing depression. Did you know that the microorganisms that live in our body are essential to the absorption of nutrients, vitamins, and the chemical balance of neurotransmitters? Most of them, estimated to be more than 100 trillion, are in our intestines. Besides that, the intestine is also where 90% of our serotonin receptors are, which not only interfere with our mood and inhibit pain, but also regulate sleep and appetite. More than that, according to studies, it has been proved that there is a very complex communication between the brain and the intestine, affecting different systems of our body, such as the endocrine nervous system, immune system, autonomic nervous system, and the enteric nervous system. So to the experts, it's possible to modify your intestinal environment throughout your life by consuming more prebiotics, probiotics, and foods like whole grain cereal, fruits, vegetables, dairy, legumes, beans, peas, lentils, soy, chickpea, eggs, and meat, fish, chicken, and lean meats. You should also control your fat consumption. Now tell us, have you done a diet that made you less anxious and sad? If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more recipes and tips, subscribe to the channel.